Hello students, welcome back to our YouTube channel Don Bosco School Tinsukia. Today I will discuss about arithmetic progressions. Arithmetic progression, or AP in short, AP is a series of numbers. Series of numbers in which the difference between any two consecutive number numbers is same all throughout the series. So AP is a series of numbers, or we can say it as list of numbers also, in which the difference between any two consecutive numbers, or we can say consecutive terms also, is same all throughout the series or list of numbers. Let us see what is the general form of an AP. It is given by A, comma A plus D, comma A plus 2D, comma A plus 3D dot dot. So general form an AP is given by A, comma A plus D, comma A plus 2D, comma A plus 3D dot dot dot, where A stands for the first term, where A means what? A means the first term, and D is the common difference, and D is the common difference. So here we can see the general form an AP is given by A, comma A plus D, comma A plus 2D, comma A plus 3D dot dot dot, where A means the first term and D means the common difference. Now we'll solve some problems. We'll see whether a given list of numbers or a series of numbers can form an AP or not. We'll take some examples. Let me erase it. Question, let us take, write first four terms of the AP whose first term is say 5 and the common difference is 2. So we are going to solve a problem. We are given what? Write first four terms of an AP whose first term is 5 and the common difference is 2. So first term means A. So here, as I have seen, we have seen already that first term is represented by the letter small letter A. So A equal to 5 given, and common difference, it is represented by D. So D is given here 2. And we have also seen that the general form an AP is A into A plus, A comma A plus D comma A plus 2D dot dot dot. So here first term is already given here 5. We will have to find 4 more terms. Therefore, A equal to 5, which is the first term. So we can write here first term, then second term, it is represented by A plus D, A plus D. So A is our 5 plus D is 2. So 5 plus 2, that is equal to 7, which is our second term. Then third one is a plus 2d. A plus 2d, that means 5 plus 2 into d's value is how much? D's value is, it is 2. So here 2d means 2 into 2. That will give us 5 plus 4 equal to 9. It is third term. Then a plus 3d. A plus 3d. So 5 plus 3 into d. D is 2 once again. So which will give us 5 plus 6? 11, fourth term. So how many terms have you written so far? You see, first term which is already given, we have calculated ourselves, second term, third term, fourth term. That means three terms we have calculated ourselves. But in question we are asked to find how many terms? Four terms. That means we need to find here one more term. That means fifth term we have to find. So how to find fifth term? Fifth term. To find fifth term, we'll have to write a plus 4d. A plus 4d. So a is 5 plus 4 into d. D is how much? 2. So this gives us 5 plus 8 means 13. So 13, it is the fifth term. So we have got the four terms as 7, then 9, 11, and lastly it is 13. 7, 9, 11, and 13. Okay. Let us take another example where we will check whether a given list of numbers can form AP or not. Okay, question is check whether root 2 comma root 3 comma root 18 comma root 32 can form an AP or not. Can form an AP or not. AP or not. To check whether a list of numbers can form an AP or not, we'll have to find some differences. We'll have to find the differences between two consecutive terms. That means second term minus first term we'll do third term minus second term, we'll do fourth term minus third term, etc. So two or three checking if we do, and in all cases, if we see our difference is same, in that case we can say that they can form an AP. But if the differences cannot come same, in that case our answer will be no, the given list of numbers cannot form an AP. Let's check. So here second term is given root 3 and first term is given root 2. So second term minus first term. Second term minus first term. So second term root 3 minus first term, it is root 2. So root 3 and root 2, they are unlike. So further simplification is not possible and they will remain just like this. Let's see now third term minus second term. What can we get? Third term minus second term. So third term is given how much here? It is root 18 minus second term given how much? It is root 3. So root 18. 18 if we factorize, that will give us 2 into 3 square, 2 into 3 square minus root 3. So from this 3 square, 1 3 can come outside. It will become root 2 minus root 3. Now you can see the difference between second term and first term and difference between third term and second term. While we found the difference between second term and first term, we got root 3 minus root 2. We got difference between second term and first term is root 3 minus root 2. But in case of difference between third term and second term, it is coming 3 root 2 minus root 3. So what do you think? Are they same? Obviously not. Here it is root 3 minus root 2, but here it is 3 root 2 minus root 3. So they are not same. So since second term minus first term, second term minus first term is not equal to what? Third term minus second term. third term minus second term. So the given numbers are not in AP. So the given numbers are not in AP. So given numbers, they cannot form AP. If we get here difference same, second term minus first term equal to third term minus second term equal to fourth term minus third term, etc. If we get same difference, in that case the list of numbers will form AP, otherwise not. Now here another formula, new formula for you. Nth term of an AP is given by an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. A few minutes ago we saw that the general form of an AP is given by a comma a plus d comma a plus 2d comma dot dot dot. So in that general form, if we want to find the nth term, then we will have to use this formula. And the formula is an equal to an, it is the nth term, or we can call it as last term also. So nth term of an AP is given by a plus n minus 1 into d, where a means the first term and d means the common difference. And nth term, it is the term number for which we want to find. So using this formula, we are going to solve two problems. Suppose this first question we are given here, a equal to 7, d equal to 3, n equal to 8. A equal to 7, d equal to 3, n equal to 8, then find an. So we'll find an. At first let us do this first question. So a given how much? First question, number one solution. A given it is 7, then d given 3, d equal to 3 and n equal to 8. Therefore, an equal to formula is a plus n minus 1 into d. Now we are going to find nth term. Now in place of n, what will come? 8, because here n equal to given 8. So therefore a8 is equal to a is how much? It is 7. So in place of a, we'll write 7 plus n. N how much? N is 8. So in place of n, it is 8 minus 1. It will remain same in its own place. And d's value given how much? It is 3. So d is our 3. So 7 plus 8 minus 1, that will give us 7. So 7 and then into 3. So 7 plus, here 7 3 are 21, and finally 7 plus 21, that will give us 28, which is our answer. So if we know the formula, then it is very easy to calculate to find nth term of an AP. The formula, once again let us recall it. The formula for finding nth term of an AP is given by an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So if you learn this formula, then any problem you can solve. And if you see this formula here, three things are there. One is nth term, one is a, in fact four things are there. One is nth term, one is a, one is n, and the last one is d. So among these four things, if we are given any three of them, then the fourth one we can calculate just by using this formula, that an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Let us move to the next question. In second question, we are given if a equal to minus 18, n equal to 10, an equal to 0. This time we are given an's value. In previous question, we found an's value, but this time we are given an's value and we have to find d's value. We are asked to find. So same formula once again we have to apply, and like previous sum, once again we'll write those values which we are given to us. So a equal to given minus 18, a equal to minus 18, then n equal to 10, an equal to 0, and d equal to question mark. So same formula will apply for solving this problem. Second problem, we know that second formula is an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now instead of writing an in left hand side, what we can do, we can write an in right hand side also, same matter. So an equal to something or something equal to an, both are same thing. So we know that a plus n minus 1 into d, that equal to an. In previous case we wrote an in left hand side, but this time we are writing it in right hand side. This is just for our convenience, so that easily we can solve the problem. Otherwise by writing in left side also we can solve the problem. Now just looking at up, we'll substitute the values. So a means how much? It is minus 18. So in place of a we'll write minus 18 plus n. Do you know the value of n? Yes, we know. It is how much? N equal to 10. So in place of n we'll write 10 minus 1. Then d, do you know the value of d? No. In fact, we are asked to calculate the value of d. So d will remain as d only. So it will remain same. And is equal to an. Do you know the value of an? An's value, are we given? Yes. How much it is? 0. So in place of an, we'll write 0. Now we'll solve. First of all, we'll send this minus 18 to right hand side. And on changing the side, minus 18 will become plus 18. Rest things will remain same in its own place. At the same time, we can calculate also 10 minus 1, that will give us 9 with it d. So 9d equal to minus 18, after changing the side, it will become plus 18. So 9d equal to 18. So this implies d equal to 18 by 9. And on dividing 18 by 9, that will give us 2. So d equal to 2. So we are asked to find the value of d, which we have got. So this is our answer. So just we have to remember the formula that an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. And here in this formula, four things are there. If we are given any three of them, then the fourth one we can find by using the same formula, an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This an sometimes we write in left side, sometimes we write in right hand side. This is just for our convenience. Any side we can write, that is not a problem. We'll discuss some more problems. Let me to erase it. One question, the 17th term of an AP exceeds its 10th term. Exceeds its 10th term by 7. Find the common difference. Question is find the common difference. So our question is, the 17th term of an AP exceeds means more, it's more than its 10th term. So 17th term is more than its 10th term. Exceeds words means more than. So 17th term exceeds 10th term by how much? By 7. If it is, then question is, find the common difference. So common difference means which letter's value or which variable's value we'll have to find. Yes, it is d. Common difference is represented by small letter d. So d's value we'll have to find. So we'll have to start our problem solution with this fact that 17th term of an AP. How to denote it, 17th term? 17th term can be denoted as A17. 17th term of an AP can be denoted as A17. This means 17th term of an AP. So 17th term of an AP exceeds its 10th term. That means the difference between 17th term and 10th term is 7. Let me to repeat once again. 17th term of an AP exceeds its 10th term. This means difference between 17th term and 10th term is 7, where 17th term should be greater, because 17th term exceeds, means 17th term is more than. So A17 minus 10th term, it is denoted by A10, 10th term it is represented by A10. So the difference between 17th term and 10th term is equal to how much? How much is it? 7. Now A17, for finding 17th term of an AP, there is one shortcut formula also. We can write A17 as A plus 16D. 17th term can be written as A plus 16D. So we will write it as A plus 16D. We will keep it inside bracket. Then minus 10th term, which is A10. A10 can be written as A plus 9D. A plus 9D. This A plus 16D, this means 17th term, this also once again we can get from that formula only, that An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. From there only we can get A17 means A plus 16D. If you wish, you can see like this, our formula is An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Now here N, N means how much? N means 17th term, so A17. So A17 equal to A plus, so in place of N how much have we written? It is 17. So in place of this N also we will have to write the same number, that is 17. So A plus 17 minus 1 into D. So A plus, now 17 minus 1, 17 minus 1 will give us 16, and with it D. So like this way, A17 means A plus 16 D. Similarly A10 means A plus 9 D. So that equal to right hand side, it will remain same. That is 7. Next work is to remove the bracket. So outside this bracket there is no sign. No sign itself means plus sign is there, so simply we can remove it. But outside this bracket, since there is minus sign, so if we don't write this bracket, we will have to change the sign of both the terms. Let's do. So here A plus 16D minus. So plus A will become now minus A, and plus 9D will become minus 9D, that equal to 7. So cancellation we can do, this plus A minus A, they are cancelled, this 16D minus 9D. So we are left with now 16D minus 9D, that will give us 7D. So 7D equal to 7. Finally, this 7 will go to right hand side, and after changing the side, it will become the denominator of right hand side, because 7 is related to D by the operation of multiplication. So on changing the side, 7 will become the denominator, which will give us D equal to 7 by 7, and after cancellation that gives D equal to 1. So that is our question, find the common difference. So our common difference is 1. So final one conclusion can be written, therefore the required common difference, the required common difference is equal to how much? 1.